But I'm sure it won't have any strings attached later down the line.
The airship that we're going to attempt to steal as everybody observes how to use it.
And if I remember correctly, on Harshnag's map, which, Rob, I noticed something on the layers. You have to unlock the map to use the layers, it looks like.
Yeah, I just discovered that as well last time.
So looking at the map here, you all were going to the Great Worm Cavern, if I remember correctly.
All up in the cavern. That is correct.
That's what she said.
That's what she said. All up in the cavern.
I have the Great Worm who has the cavern.
Right, so...
She said it's like a worm in a cavern.
It's like a... Oh my god, that was pretty good right there. I don't care who you are.
Would that be an inch farm or a...
Hang on a second. This map here is a little wonky. Oh, there's no push pins enabled. All right, so give me 1 second. I'll be right back. I gotta grab something.
The Great Worm Cavern.
Okay, yeah, the DM map is not actually labeled at all as to what is what. I mean, I know what is what, but yeah. All right, so let's see here. Get y'all on the map.
Well, what's what, but who's on first?
What's up, 1952?
All right, so this is the big map. We'll give it just a second to load up.
Oh, man.
As I crash everybody's fantasy grounds.
Got it.
I got it.
Okay.
Yep, cool. I got it.
So there is the top view that we will be using. And let me show you the side view just so you kind of have an idea of what you're looking at. All right, so there's your side view. Y'all are obviously approaching from the left. You've got, looks like little caverns kind of running up into the mountainside. And then you've got some sort of totem pole that you can kind of see. And then further in the difference, you see some sort of altar of sorts, and then the very back of the cave is a gong.
Did you say a dong?
Yes, long duck dong.
Get it on, bang a gong. I have no idea what that was.
I
don't
know where that came from.
Because nothing happened in chat that would have caused that. I don't know what the hell, man. That was crazy. I thought you were, you know, that 16 candles and you said long duck dawn. And I was about to say, what's happening, hot stuff? But then that music started. And I thought you did it on purpose. That was fucking hilarious. Oh, the icy, windy cave.
All of the unintentional comedy tonight.
So we're looking for some kind of artifact here, right?
That is correct, yes.
Do we know what artifact we're supposed to be finding?
Should be in the Oracle notes, correct?
No. We are not told what they look like.
All right, I guess we should walk up.
Well, y'all can move on in there.
Is our lighting situation decent?
Yeah, your lighting situation is decent. So as y'all get to there...
It really should have been Barrett's question. Is the lighting good?
Yeah. You all hear this voice in your head that...
It says, did I leave the toaster on?
Tells you to turn away, that the tribe here is under the influence of evil.
Oh, yeah?
My kind of guys.
All right, we'll see you. You think that's going
to
make us...
We just need to pick up something, and then we'll be going.
Well, we tried, fellas.
Yep. Somebody told us they were closed, so we left. So it reiterates that the tribe here is under the influence of an evil warlord by the name of Wormblood.
Dude, where's my car?
Didn't we kill him? Who is the guy in the Temple of the Allfather? Like at the doors, how there was a group of people?
Yeah.
I know we killed the princess.
Well, remember that there was
she a princess? I thought she was just a barbarian in a web. But we killed a bunch of barbarians.
Yeah, the ones that were working on the door that had the... Dragon Wormley.
Yeah, I'll tell this. I think we killed Wormblood. We killed a Wormblood.
It asks you for proof.
I mean, head on over to the Temple of the Allfather. We left the body there, right?
Yeah. Because I don't think we recovered anything off of her.
Show whatever it is, the axe that you have with Wormblood's blood on it.
Yeah, I thought that y'all cut his head off, I thought, to take with you.
I don't remember chopping any heads off, but I mean, if we need to go back and chop off a head, I think we can do it. We've got an airship.
No, but we did. We chopped off a guy's head and put it in a bag, right? Didn't we put it in a bag?
I don't remember that, but I'll take your word for it.
That sounds familiar.
Yeah, honestly, I think that y'all did, actually.
Yeah.
It's part of the storyline, so we did.
I think, honestly, Oxnard did it.
Is that why Oxnard has smelled this bad the whole trip? Does he have a rotting head in his pouch?
Probably. Is that what I think he does.
That sounds like something I would do.
Show him the head, Oxnard.
Okay.
I whip it out. Oh, you want the head. Wrong head.
And you show him the head you have.
What was the piece of the breastplate armor that somebody ended up with?
Didn't you end up with it?
I think I had the +2 breastplate. There were a pair of runes we found, like one ice and one fire.
Neither of them had, none of the Uthgard clan had the runes.
Right.
Yeah, I was trying to
remember. The breastplate, wasn't that from like a body inside the Oracle realm? And it like...
Yeah, that came off of the...
There was a dead giant.
Yeah, the dead giant, that's right.
what did we get off the out of the spider, or what did y'all get out of the spiders?
There was like a frozen potion, maybe, and then we found a barbarian, and she wasn't very helpful, so she ended up dying.
Yeah.
Mysterious causes.
Yeah, it was very mysterious.
I have no clue what happened.
She came down with this acute case of axe in the head.
All right, so when you say that you have already slain him, the voice urges you to approach the altar and show proof of your deeds.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, I whip out the head and I start walking up towards the altar.
All right, you can go ahead and move on up there.
I follow. I'll back him up.
Missed you covering the ground floor?
No, I was going to back him up.
Okay. All right, so you take the head out, Oxnard, and present it. And you hear a voice in your head that says, "I'm very good." And something suddenly appears in front of you. One of those appears in front of you.
Purdy.
It kind of reminds me of something I've seen before when I got into the bathroom.
Is that a coatl?
It is, yes.
Yeah.
So it says, in payment for doing this deed and hopefully freeing the tribe from the evil of Wormblood, it presents each of you with a charm of restoration.
Awesome. Whatever that is. It sounds awesome.
It's like a blessing, right?
Oh, like, no. I like does something much more.
Restoration.
It's in the party sheet if somebody wants to grab them. One apiece.
That's pretty.
Boom. Greater restoration.
And pretty or sweet. Yeah, greater and a lesser. Six charges.
Yeah, but you take multiple charges per cast.
Yeah.
Oh, so you can use it. Oh man, and then they're gone.
Three charges of lesser, one greater, one lesser.
All right. So right. As that stuff appears in front of you, the quaddle fades back out of view and disappears.
Wait. Where did my charm go?
It should be.
I don't know.
It's weird. It says Party Garrett, Charm of Restoration, Party Brett Blank, Party Miss, Charm of Restoration.
Yeah, that is weird, because there's nothing left in the inventory.
I wonder if somebody tried to grab one at the same time as I tried to grab one.
And that will cause, if you guys do it exactly at the same time, it does kind of screw it up sometimes. I've had that happen before.
All right, well, give me 1 second, and I'll drop one back in the party sheet. Or I'll just drop it straight in your inventory.
I try to contact the Quaddle again and ask about the relic we're supposed to be after.
You do not hear anything from it.
Call customer service.
Damn weird looking bird.
Please hit the continue button.
Yep, you've got the altar in front of you, and then you've got the gong behind you.
I guess I will change.
Investigate the altar.
Kitty can't help but to go toward the gong for now. Mist is just gonna look at the gong. Is there a hammer hanging down to hit it with, or is it just the gong itself?
Um, Go ahead and give me a perception check.
Hey.
Okay.
Hey, Mist, put your tongue on it, see if it sticks.
Right? Never get it off.
Oh, look, Frost.
All right.
So do you know anything about a artifact here? Or is it the gong?
Emrys, you give that to me in that tower. Mist.
Sorry. Whoops.
Emrys.
Tower.
And Garrett, you investigate and see that the altar is it's about 100 and... See here. It's a frost-covered stone carved in the shape of a coiled serpent with great wings. It represents Elrim, the Great Worm.
All right, Great Worm Cavern.
So the charm is the relic?
Mist, you examine the gong, and it is a disc about 13 feet in diameter that is partially broken and appears to be missing a large piece. Give me an investigation check.
Okay.
All right, so you get the feeling that this thing weighs somewhere between 200 to 300 pounds. And it's made of a little bit of some kind of red material and also copper. And it's being held up with two ropes.
Okay, but there, and it's broken, but there's no banger that's obvious to tool to use to hit it with.
Yeah, there is no,
not there.
There is nothing there to bang on it.
Okay. So I'll go back and tell the fellas.
I got a maul. I can bang on it.
What'd you guys find at the altar?
Bird with a head fetish.
Yeah, Jack.
There doesn't seem to be anything in about the altar itself besides a representation to the Coatl we encountered already.
What with dong the dong?
Yeah, what's going on with the gong?
The gong is broken. It's got a piece missing.
So a piece missing and no striker.
No striker and a piece missing, yes.
I'm going to walk up to it. And I'll take out my maul and I'll dong the gong.
All right, go ahead and give me a strength check.
You want it in the tower?
Yep.
Did he say he was going to dong the gong?
He absolutely said that.
I think he did, yes.
I did say
that. Maybe there should be a constitution check.
Yeah.
Is it frost? Is it frost covered as well?
Now, how did you get that stuck to the gong?
All right, so Oxnard, you swing and you hit this thing, and it suddenly begins to reverberate throughout the cavern. As you do so, the ground all around you begins to shake when suddenly something emerges out of underground. You suddenly see three of those.
Oh.
That's what
Edward
killed me.
Oh boy, more Remoras, guys.
Edward G. Remoras again.
So, are there any falling rock traps around?
God damn it.
Good gonging.
That's how strong I am. I brought three of them. I'm so strong.
God, y'all's initiative. Holy shit.
Well, I'm standing in the right place.
Well, I got a 12, which isn't half bad for Garrett.
And I got a whopping one.
All right, so this guy is going to burrow. This guy here. I'm going to move to here.
Bye, Oxnard.
And bite out at Oxnard and miss.
Well, their baby room arises.
That one over here.
They'll hurt, but they won't suck as big as the big one.
Miss. All right, Garrett, you're up.
Alrighty. Thinking what to do. Alright, so bonus action, spiritual weapon.
Alright, let's see what we have for you tonight. Where do you want it at?
I will put it opposite of one of the youngins. That way it's we've got flanking on it.
No
Oxnard.
Flanking.
Well, yeah, it won't be. Yeah, it will be flanking for them, right? No, that's right. No flanking. It's got to be illegal.
Right, also, so spiritual weapon doesn't flank anyway.
Flanking also messes up combat balance.
So yeah. There is a polar bear. Spiritual weapon.
Okay. All right. So we got that. Okay, and then for my action, I will target the master.
I'll have to drop it on him. You didn't target him.
Really? It's this? Remorse. Okay. Yeah, okay.
The damage hit him. At the
it's out of order again.
Yeah, and since it's Firebolt and not Sacred Flame, no damage because it's fire-based. Just as I suspected, but I had to check. And I'm going to back up this way.
You gonna jump the cliff?
All right, missed.
Dun, 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 dun. I'm going in.
Animus. All right, Emrys.
All righty, let me see.
Yeah, it's putting the hit or the miss before the thing again. Yeah, it was doing that last night for us too.
I will just step to there and target the same one for now.
Nice hit.
Swing the hit. You hit twice, didn't you?
Oh, I'm double clicking?
No, I'm saying you hit him twice.
Yeah, it looks like he's hit him all three attacks.
Okay, three attacks. All right.
Yeah, I have the extra attack plus my bonus action.
No, that's fine. I just needed to know how many times for you to take your heated body.
Did I roll damage for the last one? Now I've lost track.
You haven't rolled damage.
Damage since the first one.
Yeah, since the
first one. No, I rolled.
Yeah, it didn't. You didn't have him targeted. So hang on one second.
Oh, it dropped target for some reason.
Then I'll just roll one more damage at him.
Yeah, it dropped my target for some reason, because I did have him targeted. Alright.
Alright, let's throw a pattern at him.
Banned spell.
Band spell.
Resisted both times.
Oxnard.
How big are these youngins compared to me? I'm 8 foot tall.
They are large creatures. It doesn't
They'd say be relatively the same size.
Yeah. Maybe a little bit taller than you.
What if I could ride one of these things?
I don't know. Can you ride a stovetop?
Yeah.
I've got a saddle. I've been carrying it around all this time.
Yeah, probably.
And they are made out of fire.
All right, we're going to go ahead and do this with the minus five to get the extra damage.
All right. Swing and a hit.
And attack number two.
And that one's dead.
That'd be dead. I only have two attacks, but you know what? I'm going to action surge right off the bat. Let's just get this out of the way right now.
Why'd you attack twice?
Mortality clarified in a single strike.
Yep, that's right.
Love them ones. All right, and that ends my turn.
All right.
What was resisted?
God, I'm freaking... I dragged his fire damage on himself. All right, Garrett, you're up.
Did he try to touch himself?
He did, yes. He was biting his tail.
Bonus action over to there. And then. Let's see here. And we'll try the chill touch this time.
And we can miss.
Yep. Okay.
All right,
Meow Meow coming over.
He hasn't attacked yet, has he?
Why do you say that?
Or no, yeah, he's already acted. Never mind.
I rolled the wrong thing. Hold on. There we go.
Yeah.
I hit twice, but I rolled a hit instead of damage, so I hit twice. And do I know why I'm taking damage when I hit him?
Yeah, I would assume as you hit him, you understand that that's kind of hot.
Okay, so I'm taking fire damage when I hit him. Okay. Yep.
Hot water burn, baby.
I don't like it. Burn baby. Don't burn baby.
All right, so this thing spins around and goes after the cat behind him and attempts to bite and misses. All right, Emrys?
You goddamn right he does.
All righty, I step up and take my three attacks. I didn't hit.
Oxnard, what are you doing? Hang on, don't do anything.
Alrighty.
I'm not doing nothing.
You just rolled a crossbow attack. Alright, Emrys, so you missed the first one, you hit the second one. Go ahead and roll your damage.
Fantasy Grounds is going crazy.
That's how I said, because I'm not even, my keyboard's on a table away from me.
It's like craziness.
That is awkward.
They've automated it a little too much. Now it's playing by itself.
Yeah, it just doesn't need us at all.
Right.
Man, this AI stuff's getting a little too crazy.
All right, I will end my turn there.
All right, Barith.
So that burrowed one has not made his presence known yet, huh?
No, it went underground and hasn't come back up.
It's underground.
no guesses as to where it might appear.
All right. I'm going to stay and put, and I'll move a little bit, and ready in action to hypnotize anyone that pops out of the ground near me. Since you guys appear to have this well in hand.
All right. So popping out of the ground directly in front of you is right there. So go ahead and do your thing. And it failed. All right, Oxnard.
I got 23 wounds already from these things.
You do, man.
Son of a bitch.
Hot water burn baby.
And you wanted to ride it a moment ago.
Yeah. You don't ride
a stove.
Ramirez rides you.
That's my first attack.
All right.
In my turn.
All righty. All right, missed. You're up, sir.
All right. Here comes some more rapier action. That is an adjective. Boom.
Bye-bye.
And yep. I will run over here. Now, he's hypnotized, right? But he's the only one left, so should I start whacking on him?
Do what you need to do, man.
All right, here we go.
I'm just glad he didn't attack me.
I'm just kidding. I didn't want to hit him.
Garrett, you're up, sir.
It was good. I fell for it.
All right. Bonus action back over to here. And then Sacred Flame.
It failed.
And that'll be all.
Alrighty. I will just go ahead and take myself over here and attack it.
Alright.
Okay, it's just upside down now.
All right, my question is, do I know how far out this fire would reach me if I were to attack it?
It's gonna
seems to be melee.
Yeah, it's melee. You know that if you hit it with something.
But what I'm saying is, if I hit my axe up and went to my glaive, which has got a 10 foot reach, would I still get burned?
You'd be fine.
Yeah, you should be fine.
Yeah, you have to be within 5 feet of it.
Pike weapons are actually ideal for dealing with them.
Yep.
Yeah, I moved there, and while I was moving, I was putting my axe up and drawing my glaive out.
All right.
Nice. I gotta get the balance of it yet. I've been using that axe. I get a little bit out of balance right now.
Swinging a whiff.
Shit, I forgot I had set that up. That's pretty funny.
That's nice.
Sweet.
Alrighty, and that ends my turn.
Alright, Barrett.
Alright, let's get between a couple of allies and Thunderwave him.
And supervise.
It doesn't show me their success or failure.
He succeeded.
He succeeded, so he'll take half damage. Go.
Alrighty. So it is going to attack.
And it's Barrett. No longer charmed.
And miss.
That's never going to get old.
I missed. You're up.
Okay. Yes. I will proceed.
Swing and a miss.
What about this one?
There you go.
Not dead.
And Garrett.
All right. Ew, bonus action. And followed up with the Sacred Flame again.
He succeeded.
Okay. So much for that.
All right, Demeris.
I will swing third time.
There you go.
Such a terrible assault cannot be left unanswered.
All right, and with that, the last one falls dead. And you notice that there appears to be the three holes where they burrowed up out of seem to be leading down into kind of like a shadow cavern underneath. And give me 1 second.
I suddenly realize how hard I am, and I'm like, ow, ow.
Yeah. Yeah, blood all over you.
I'm going to walk up and I'm going to be like, hey, bud, it's not so bad.
I have a couple potions.
All right, that should be fine for now. Might want to take care of Oxnard.
Yeah. You got a couple chunks taken out of you, don't you there, Oxnard?
Yeah, that's why I didn't get so close the second time around. I was like, holy crap. I went below half damage.
That should make you feel a little better.
Yeah, it makes you feel real better. Especially when you touched me, I like that.
Be one more second, guys. I'm sorry.
No worries. I'm just healing the guys up.
I wonder if it would be worth doing prayer of healing if you have it prepared.
Did not. I've got a mass healing word, but...
No, I've always considered prayer of healing like really good out of combat spell, but it takes 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Do we think we want to go down these holes, everybody? What are we going to do?
Oh, yeah, we'll probably go down the holes to continue looking for the relic.
I wonder if either these totems or the gong might be the relic.
I'm wondering if the missing piece of the gong...
Maybe the gong itself is the relic and it's broken right now?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that might just be like a chip on it or something.
I'm not wondering at all.
Be a relic, right? Thinking.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Thing hurts.
Kids were fighting. All right. So yeah, you kill the Remorazes, and you see what looks to be some kind of opening, like layer down underneath where they burrowed up out of.
Oxnard, did you want to crawl in there?
Not particularly. A little too small for me.
Well, should we finish scanning around topside before we head under?
Well, I mean, we'll have to come out back here eventually.
I mean, how big are these tunnels? I mean, if I were to go in it, would I be able to swing an axe?
Yeah, it's, I mean, they just, these, like, burrow holes appear to be all leading down, and there's, like, a 20-foot room down underneath there. Like, where they were layered and sleeping. Yeah, kind of like a nest.
Is it a straight drop down, or?
Yeah, I mean, you can drop down in there with some rope or something.
That's what I'm asking, so we need to do some rope up here.
Yeah, attach a rope around the gong area, and then we'll go down.
Yeah, I was going to say that's what I did.
Okay, so Emrys, you affix a rope and kind of just rappel down in there?
Yeah.
Emrys on rappel. All
right. So down inside there, you find some items and stuff down in there, just kind of scattered across the floor. You find 15 gemstones, 3 large gemstones, and a bottle that appears to be, that contains, looks like liquefied iron. And you recognize it as a potion of invulnerability.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
The cat sees the rope and thinks it reminds him of yarn and is tempted to pull it up.
Bad kitty.
Rolls over on his back and gets himself knotted up in it.
All right. So, Emrys, you get back out. What do y'all do here?
So, no trace of the broken piece of the gong so far?
Nope. Why didn't somebody else examine the gong, give me an investigation check?
I'll take a look at the gong.
All right.
I'll look at it since we're...
So what you're saying is I rolled shit when I did it.
no need to, Barath. Kind of turn around and look at Mist a little bit, like, seriously? You didn't recognize that this thing used to be the remnants of a... large shield that a frost giant had, and that it's made of red dragon scales bolted to a copper frame. There's even some spots on the back where leather arm straps go. And you like turn back and miss. You seriously didn't see all this?
All right, guys, we're going to have to get it together in the future. We can't just overlooking important objects like this.
He says, "You done with that rope?"
That's all he's thinking about now.
All right, let's have those schlubs from the airship come and wheel this onto our boat.
All right, so they do so. They come down, lop it off with the with some swords, just real easy, and they towed it back to your ship.
Awesome.
Chip chop, guys. No slacking. I'm looking at you, cultist number 3.
You there with the red shirt, you better...
But he's just looking at your bulge. He's having a hard time working with that, you know, outfit number 5 on.
I'm wearing outfit number 2.
Well, that makes it even worse.
All right. So you make it back to your airship with your...
You can tell the difference.
...relic. Oh, Oxnard is a connoisseur in outfits.
Despairs.
It helps that they're different colors.
All right, so where would you like to head to next?
Shining White. Are we just making that loop through the nearest four?
Yeah, I think that's what we discussed.
All right. Fly on, ship persons.
Yeah, what he said.
All right, just give me 1 second here.
At least it'll be in slightly warmer climate. We won't have to be dealing with rubber eyes.
Oh, stewardess, what's the flight time and the in-flight entertainment?
All right, so let's see here. Let me get you back.
The flight time will be 2 weeks.
Go ahead and arrange yourself on the airship there.
And for the in-flight entertainment, he offers you the cabin boy.
I'm going to go ahead and load up the basslet and be ready. Let's collect this toy.
Continuing to study the guy that runs the fires.
They kind of look at you. Hey guys, what are you taking notes for? What the hell's going on here?
Oh, nothing to see here.
Why are you taking notes? That's awesome.
I'm educated. That's why I take notes.
All right, so it is a 350-mile journey. You go 8 miles an hour.
Carry the 7.
Is that the airship's max speed is 8 miles an hour?
Airship A leaves spot B at 8 miles per hour to go 355 miles.
It takes
how long
you,
will it take to cross spot C?
43 hours to get there. So almost 2 days.
I will rest.
Yeah, I think I'm going to take a rest.
Of course. So let's see here. So there's your rest. Let's see if anything exciting happens.
Or rather, when something exciting happens.
I got that. You said when.
So you are suddenly beset upon by
your mother, Trebek.
Your mother.
I'll take anal bum covers.
All right, let me. This. Alright, roll initiative.
Also soon.
Hey, we gotta get XP in some way.
Yep. Try not to get too far behind the power curve.
Alright. First up is Manticore number 6. Going to swoop down here at Oxnard.
When your name ends in number 6, you know you're not meant to live long.
And sure. Bite and hit. And claw once and critically
strike.
Death waits
for the slightest lapse in concentration.
And third. All right, this guy here will swoop down out of the sky and make three... tail spike attacks at Mist. There's one, two, and three. All right, Oxnard.
Alrighty, I will go ahead and don't like this guy very much. Do my freaking strike great weapons. I tell him that I don't like him very much. Please go away. And action surge.
Alright. Miss is getting all excited with the prospect of birds flying around.
I hear the birds.
That way, my turn.
Turn around, look at Miss. He's got a mouthful of feathers. What?
I didn't do it.
Barith.
All right, Manticore 12. I'll tell him the joke about the worm in the cavern. Cast Tasha's hideous laughter.
And he fails. And what does he do exactly again?
He falls prone and is incapacitated, both of which are very bad effects when you're flying.
Yep, so he plummets to the ground. Let's see here. I wonder how high we're flying.
12,000 feet.
You are terminal velocity. Flying 80 feet off the ground. Is it 1d6
so
for 8 10
feet?
Six.
Yeah.
I think so.
For 29 damage.
Upon taking damage, he will repeat his save.
He succeeded.
All right, so he'll wake up. It's not so funny anymore now that he fell to the ground.
Yeah. Now that I've had time to think about that. All right, Miss Sir.
So the one that fell to the ground was number 12, yeah?
That is correct.
Ha-ha! Ungod!
I like how you made him small.
Yeah.
Gotta add for that realism going on here.
You needed to do the Wilhelm scream.
Have it slowly get quieter.
And damn it, I missed. Ah, crap. Okay. You know what? I'm not going to waste the bonus action. I'll wait.
All right, Emrys.
All right. I move up and I move in to attack. Let me target him. But...
I'm going to miss. Second one's a miss. Third one's a critical strike.
There it is.
Nice job.
So now we got a dead manticore on the deck.
And in my turn.
Alright, so this guy will fly up 50 feet. Almost there. Not quite. So he is 30 feet underneath the boat.
I am going to drop both my rapiers.
Off the side. See you later. Woo!
No, not off the side. And I'm going to pull my short bow and try to get this guy. Ooh. That's bad. And then I'm going to move maybe over here.
I'll sit here and try to think up another joke.
All right, Garrett.
Down to here. Target him down there. Since I've got 120-foot range on this, and try it again. And hit him that time. Oh, shitty roll. All
right, Emrys.
I move to my position and wait for the manticore to come up.
All right, you're gonna ready in action?
Not exactly. I don't know where it's gonna show up, but if he comes within 5 feet of me, I'll attack.
Okay. All right, Oxnard.
I'm going to sit down and pull out my pillow out of my pack and go ahead and take me a long rest.
I think you should spin the trebuchet around and aim it down towards him and fire it through the boat.
Yeah, no, I'm not going to do that. I thought about that, but that's probably not what I want to do. I'll just go ahead and, with my axe in my hand, just kind of stand here and ready in case he comes within attack range.
Okay. All right, Mistra.
All right, I guess I'll run to the side of the boat and take another shot.
Nice.
And I believe I pretty much have to stay on there. I can't really run away.
I will ready another Tasha's to be cast when he comes up to boat level.
Okay. He is now up to boat level.
About the time we hid Catnip and Miss Pillow at the inn.
And it does not find that very funny, and again plummets to the ground.
We find it very funny.
And
fuck you.
All right. Emrys, you're up. I would just like to point out that I don't believe Barath has ever directly damaged something and killed it. It's always indirect.
I did cast Thunderwave and dealt 4 damage last fight.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right.
That he did.
Didn't kill anything, but, you know, it probably was what softened him up enough for the rest of the party to defeat.
Very, very indirect way of killing stuff. All right, Garrett.
All right. I'm just going to try to hit him with a firebolt since it's got the range.
All right.
Not that way.
Oh, my God.
You're right, though. It's a good
sound effect.
It never gets old.
You fucking...
All right, Oxnard.
He's back down to the ground again, right?
He is, yes.
I'm sorry, Oxnard.
Hold your axe over the side and eyeball it up and just drop it.
Not so much a good idea, I don't think.
All right, missed, you're up.
Okay, so he's 80 feet away, right? So that's
that
good.
Is correct.
Well, that's not that good.
Oh, did he make his save when he hit the ground? Let's see.
Oh, yep, he did not. He failed.
Then at the start of his turn, he makes it again.
He succeeded.
Or it's actually at the end of each of its turn, it makes the save.
All right, so he doesn't do anything this round, correct?
Right.
Yeah, because right. He failed.
He's rolling around on the ground laughing.
Oxnard, drop.
I'm going to squeeze into there.
Drop rocks on him.
And I'm going to pull my thing out, and I'm going to start peeing over the side of the boat toward him.
All right.
What if it's just one of the heads that's laughing, and the other two are like, you're such an idiot, as it's funny.
I'm gonna make sure that the Cult of the Dragon is steering the boat properly.
All right.
I think my work here is done.
Garrett?
One more firebolt is direction.
Much better aim.
Nice.
And you kill it.
Bye-bye.
All right, so I assume y'all are going to rest.
It was that toss to pee of mine that did it.
It clearly froze into icicles and held them.
The next day, You don't want those again? You can have one of those again.
Yay.
I'm assuming Oxnard's moved back up to his normal position on this.
Yep, everybody yeah. move into.
I don't know. Has he finished peeing? It's only been a day.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm going to ask the personnel on board if they have any extra arrows.
I've got extra arrows if you need some.
Okay, because I'm down to 9 now, because I'm assuming the 3 I just shot off the side, I'm never going to get back.
All yeah, right. they gone.
I'll give you 20.
Oh, excellent. Okay.
All right, so let's see here. Coming straight for the boat, it's coming right for us, is one of those.
Is it the same one we saw before?
Nope, y'all killed the other one. This is another one.
Oh. Oh, so it's its brother who's pissed. Okay, yep. Great.
It's looking for the six-fingered man that killed its brother, its father. Everybody roll initiative.
Fire that thing in the beginning at the whatever that thing is. The harpoon.
Ballista is what you're looking for?
Yeah, yeah. Is it the ballista? That's exactly.
The Batista, yeah, Ballista, Baristro, the coffee person.
The big bow here. And arrow.
Let's see here how high y'all are real quick. You have descended, you are 83 might feet off relevant. The ground. All right, missed.
We're at a cruising altitude of 5 feet.
All right, here we go.
What was the name of that thing?
All right, let's get a little closer so that you can hear me.
And, Ballista.
I'll tell him about the time that Oxnard peed off the side of the boat onto the Manticore.
It was appalled by this and falls to the ground.
Oh, gosh. So it'll save on damage and save at the end of its turn if it
succeeded. It succeeded.
Right.
Breaking D&D one encounter at a time.
It succeeded when it took damage.
Okay. So it will not be raffling.
Alright, so it actually flies back up 80 feet. And... makes it up to there. And we'll do a little bit of this number.
Breathe on us, guys.
Oh, snap. Do we know what kind of breath a green dragon has?
I think it's poison?
Yeah, it's chlorine.
Poison or acid?
Yeah, it's chlorine gas. Black dragons are acid.
That's right.
There's a little bit of that. There's a little bit of this. All right, Emrys, you're up.
Ow.
Fuck you, dragon. Meow.
And it's not prone anymore.
Yeah.
Is it the distance off the ship it says it is? It's 10 feet away?
Yes.
Then I will do...
Can you stay in that square?
Huh?
Can you stand in that square?
Can I stand in... Why would I stand in that square?
You'd be 5 feet away?
Why do I want to be 5 feet from it?
Oh, I thought you wanted to stab. You can grab.
I'm trying to remember what level I am. That's 6. So yeah, this should be upgraded if I haven't already. Okay. I will lightning lure it. All right. So.
Yeah.
The succeed or fail?
It succeeded.
And it does nothing.
Is that a cantrip?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Okay. So it does all right, nothing.
The gear trip.
Bonus action. Give me something that he can dance with in the way of a spiritual weapon.
All right. Let's see here. Where do you want it at?
You can put it just off the deck of the ship below him. Yeah. We got there a horse. Nice.
A horse. Of course.
Of course.
Nice.
And then follow that up with one of these.
Oh, yeah.
Alrighty.
And I'm going to stay put.
Alright, Oxnard.
Alright, I know I'm not very smart character-wise, so, but I am a weapons genius. I would realize that that probably would not do very much damage, right? At 10 feet?
The ballista?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you're pretty close to him. I would hope that you would be able to hit him.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is it doesn't, really wouldn't have enough time to get to speed, though, right? Or would it? I wouldn't think it would.
It'll do the same amount.
You mean, speed is generated
at
the point of launch.
Yep, it'll do the same amount of damage.
Okay, that's what I wanted to make sure. Okay. Well, then, what's the attack with the ballista?
Just roll a d20. And we'll add 6 to it. So that would be a 17, which misses. It's able to deftly dodge out of the way.
Okay. I guess I will stay here.
All right. I had missed you.
All right, I'm going to go here, drop my bow, pick up one of my rapiers, and if you will allow me, I'm going to kick my other rapier so that it tries to land up here somewhere. You can tell me if I'm successful with that.
All right, give me an... give me an...
Catabatrix stick.
An athletics. Well, do you want to do it like pop it on your toe, flipping it like in style, or just kick it?
I just want to kick it because I don't want it to fly over the edge.
All right, so give me an athletics.
What's the odds he sticks it in his foot?
All right, so it lands where you want it to. Oh, believe me, if he had a rolled one, it was going over the edge.
Fuck. All right, so I'm only going to get one attack this turn, so I will take it. Oh. Fucker. What did I see the last effect grant? Disadvantage attack. Oh, I don't know. That was something that Garrett did.
Yeah, and it's only against me.
Okay. I will sit here in my wah, wah, wah. But I am going to put on.
I will command him to approach.
He succeeds.
No effect.
All right, to Garrett.
All right. Spiritual weapon first. And then it's hitting with some fire this time. But I missed.
Alrighty, can I get to like in there somewhere? If I can't, I'll just
you go. Can either move to there on the edge or there 10 feet away.
I'll go the 10 feet away and draw my glaive and attack with it.
Okay, because if you were going to straddle the edge like that, you were going to do an athletics check.
No, I was not going to straddle the edge.
Somebody might have been doing some flying.
Where's your daring?
That's my daring right there.
Good daring.
All right, so it is going to continue its flight straight up and land right here.
Ooh, that means op attack, doesn't it?
It does.
Excellent.
Sweet.
That's funny. He followed my command even though he saved.
All right. And he is going to bite out at Emrys and hit.
Bye, Emrys.
Can I shield that?
Can you shield that?
Yes.
Okay. Can I? Can you?
All right, so it is going to claw at you and hit. And claw at you again.
Death.
Oh dear. Oh my god.
It's all right, man. Gotcha.
And drop Emrys to the ground.
Nat 20 here. Nat 20. You're getting right back up.
Critical failure.
Okay. Well, it was a natural something.
I was like, I don't. You didn't even see what I rolled.
Wow. Okay. Pissed off, I'm going to pick up my other rapier. Come over here. Give this guy the business. Right?
The business end of your business.
What kind of business are you doing?
Not very good.
Not any kind of business at all. I'm going to give him a cat raspberry.
All right. It turns out that he really hates the feel of sandpaper tongues.
I didn't lick him.
Jesus. You didn't stick me and went by.
All right, Garrett, sir.
Pony's going to come over there as a bonus action. And I'm going to come over here and
God, miss, get to work on them birds. Jesus Christ.
This is getting louder. Shit.
They're getting closer. Roll initiative.
And then I'm going to do spare the dying on Mr. Emrys.
All right.
You have no heal available?
Yeah, actually, you know what? Fuck it. That's what I'll do.
He'll later. He just wants to build the suspense.
There you go. Get back up, bitch. No laying down on the job.
Let's glaive this bitch. Maybe not.
Good shot.
Alright, that ends my turn.
Alright, Barath.
I will continue to tell the dragon jokes.
And that one is a little bit too much, and it is laughing hysterically.
And then I will back away from the dragon.
Alright. Emrys?
Am I healed?
Yep.
Yes. Okay. I guess I stand up and attack it. With my long swords. Oh, is it prone now?
Yes.
Yep.
It is rolling on the floor laughing. You missed, though.
Yeah, you missed, though.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Go ahead and just make another attack, and if you hit, you do, we'll keep that damage.
Okay.
I'm gonna miss.
I will action damage once. For another, at least two attacks.
All right.
Nice.
Yeah.
Reeling. Nice.
Nice. Sweet revenge.
Who had the fiery rune?
Huh?
Who had the fiery rune?
I do, but we never established that I had or when, so it just never got applied.
Okay, we have been on the boat for days.
Yeah. I'll go ahead and build it out
so
now.
Let's see here. I'll clear that. I would imagine you would take another rest.
Mm-hmm.
Not quite there yet. All right. Let me bring up Harshnag's map. You were heading to the Shining White, correct?
I believe so.
Yeah.
I think we're just going to sort of make a loop on this nearest four. Because we could dig up all the artifacts. We're going to have a lot of gongs in the hull of this boat.
Right. You know what? I bet the DM's map is not grid. No, it is not. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. We drop y'all on the map. I'm going to share two maps with y'all. Oh, never mind. I don't need to. Alright, so y'all are going to land... right there. There is a toppled the M there is a toppled menhir, I guess is how you pronounce it.
And no map yet, so.
Yeah, I guess that would probably assist in seeing as I talk. All right, so you've got the top left corner is a giant white rock. The middle is a toppled altar, and the bottom left where the M is a toppled menhir. And let me give you
what is a menhir?
I don't know. Let me look it up real quick. Let me see what the Google says. It is a tall, upright stone of a kind erected in prehistoric times in Western Europe. Apparently some Europeans made their way over here and erected some stones.
Almost like one of the stones at Stonehenge or something?
Yep.
Bunch of rocks that have fallen over.
So how tall are the ledges to each different tier?
Let's see here. It does not necessarily say. We'll say that they are, let's see. 10 feet. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. That's not what I wanted to roll. 14 feet. There we go.
Okay.
All right, so let's look for an artifact, right?
Do you guys want to climb up or go around? Because I can climb up and then get a rope tied to something, maybe.
Don't we have an airship? Can't we just fly to the middle?
Oh, yeah. Can we just parallel or belay down, what's it called? Rappel down just right on to a certain spot. Can we do that?
You can, yeah. What spot do you want to drop down to?
Do we want to go to A or M?
I mean, we'll need to go to both eventually. How about we start with M? Yeah. Give us a little bit more space to practice our rappelling.
Okay.
Yeah, we can do like the southeast, like right there at the bend. That way we've got a few feet between us and the M. Okay. Yeah.
All right. So I'll go ahead and move your tokens over there then.
And then we can saunter up.
All right. So, yeah, will you go ahead and get... Do you want to examine it, or what do y'all want to do?
Yeah, we can take a look at it.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and give me some perception checks. All right. You all notice that there is nothing out of the ordinary about it. It just looks to be some stone that fell over.
Okay, nothing that looks artifact-ish, huh?
That is correct.
Do a history check, see if I can recall anything about it.
You recall that these stones might have been placed here by ancient Europeans.
All right, cool. Awesome roll, then.
You actually rolled good. There's just no historical value about it.
Copy.
Or the history would have been lost to humans.
Yes, we will go with that. It is well beyond your knowledge as a human. Or whatever race you are.
Yeah, I'm just dirty half-elf. Okay. Well,
so any here's ideas? The question. Do y'all spend the time climbing back up to your airship, moving it over
no.
about 50 feet, and then coming back down, or do you just crawl over?
My strength is 10, so I can make a long jump of 10 feet, so I'm going to run and right across the ramp.
All right, and you, of course, land on your feet.
Yeah, because I'm a cat.
Yeah. I'll take that same risk.
All right. Y'all gonna make the jump, you gonna move over there.
And now we will look at this altar. Does this look like the other altar that we saw?
It does not. Go ahead and give me some perception checks.
Perception.
Did we lose iron?
I don't think we did.
His token is over there.
Yeah, but I haven't heard him talk for a little while either.
Iron, you there?
You may have had to step away.
Maybe so.
No AFK. Party fail.
Party fail.
He's dead.
I'm not dead. I'm here.
Oh, as soon as we threaten your death, you're here.
I moved your token over to the altar. That's where we are now.
All right. So...
I was afraid he'd fallen asleep at the computer, like I almost did.
Garrett, you searched the ancient altar here, And it looks like it has been smashed to rubble.
Smashed by Barney Rubble. Got it.
And it looks like the ground may have been disturbed around it.
Are you able to tell by what?
Undisturbed ground.
Go ahead and give me an investigation, Garrett.
Sure will.
Disturbed by burrowing remoras.
You notice that it looks to have maybe been disturbed by humanoid hands.
Can I tell the size of these humanoid hands?
About the same size as yours.
Okay, cool.
Insert Trump joke here.
Where were you on the night of December whatever another?
Yeah, I turn and look at Oxnard. What do you have to say for yourself?
If it don't fit, you have to acquit.
Okay.
All right, so what do y'all do?
Any trace of an artifact?
Do you dig under the altar first?
Yes.
Sure. Okay.
Right. I'll draw my axe out and be prepared for some remorse.
Well, and you do have a cat with you.
I'll stand on top of this high rock so that I can appropriately supervise the party.
All right, so you all get to work. You dig out what appears to be two halves of something that appear to be broken, but they do look like they might be able to fit together.
I place them together.
All right, you do so, and you see that the two pieces, when placed together, form a mask that the image on the face bears a very fearsome scowl.
I put the mask on Garrett.
All right, so with that, you hear
if he allows me.
You hear a bird noise up above you, and you see four these things coming at you, and everybody roll initiative.
Oh, they look friendly. Oh, they're not friendly.
Griffins.
I thought griffins were nice people.
Gryffindor.
Just because they can be domesticated doesn't mean they're nice.
All right, Garrett, you're up.
So have I still got the stupid mask on my face?
I'd imagine you could probably take it off.
Okay.
It's not like it was probably cursed or something.
Yeah, nothing like that.
Takes it off and we're like, oh my gosh, it's hideous.
You've got something on your face.
Put it back.
And we'll see where that leads us.
All right, this guy here, what do we got? 80 feet? More than enough to get over here next to Oxnard. All right, so it'll tag once with its beak and hit, and once with its claws and miss.
You got hit with a pecker.
You did. All right, missed.
I got picked.
All right, I will step up. And I will do my attacks.
How quickly the tide turns.
Call.
Does he get advantage because it's a bird?
I missed on the second one.
Well, it's half cat, see, so.
Yeah.
So Mist is torn. He's placed in a dilemma. He wonders, did I screw a bird somewhere that I don't know about? What's going on here?
Is that a cat that swallowed a bird or a bird that's crapping out a cat?
right. Let's see here.
We'll fire here. Damage, man.
And bite at Oxnard and hit. And claw at Oxnard and hit.
All right, I'm going to stone endurance some of that damage.
All right.
Alrighty. Now it's my turn.
It is.
I'm going to hop on the back and tell this thing to go for a little ride. No, just kidding.
All right.
All right, we'll do the minus five.
That actually isn't a bad idea. Take the train, a Griffin.
Do the minus five. Action surge, do the minus five.
I feel like you're due. Goodness.
Oh, man. Oh,
wow. And I rolled two ones. I rolled a one, an eight, and a one.
1881.
It was a bad year.
It's an omen.
I'm done. I mean, literally done. Could we lose the DM too?
He said he'll be right back.
You had to go beat people.
Quick, let's jump in and re-roll my dice again. So at the second win, the next attack, I get attacked.
All right. Let's see. Guys flies to here. We'll bite Garrett and miss. That guy will claw at Garrett and miss. And Barrett, you're up.
Bad kitty bird.
Fit into 30-foot cube. That looks about right. Sleep, kitty birds. Well, one kitty bird. It's heavily damaged.
All right, Barrett, you're up.
Okay. Six. I can't quite get as close as I want to. So, I'll go to there and then firebolt at, one of the kitty birds. Kitty bird 12.
Nice.
Alrighty, I will attack Griffin 11 and see if I can't take it down.
Nice. Such a terrible assault cannot be. Alright, well, kitty bird's awake.
I'd missed. All All right, Kitty Bird is going to bite at him or beak at Emrys, and then claw at Emrys. All right, Garrett.
Okay, Garrett thinks this is a good time to cast Spiritual Guardians.
It succeeded.
Okay.
Well, they don't roll till their turn starts.
Yeah, they roll on their turn, so.
Yeah.
Have six turn.
Yeah, so I'll put it here. It's within 15 feet of me, which in my case, let me see, I'm neutral, so it'll be radiant damage whenever it's their turn. So I will have, let me see, what are there? Is there three of them?
Looks that way.
Yep. So basically one spiritual guardian up against these three. So I don't think you'll have to put anything out there. It'll just be when it's their turn.
Where does that need to be?
It's just a 15.
It's an aura area around him.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's what I thought.
Yeah, it's 15. Yeah. I'll draw it.
It's centered on him.
All right, so Griffin won?
No, Griffin lost. Your half spiritual guardian's damage to Griffin won?
For number one, yeah, here it comes.
Oh, hang on. All right. Yeah, no. Oh.
And I'm not sure if he failed or succeeded.
You can just roll damage. It isn't half if they succeed or fail or whatever.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, it works itself out.
Yep. All right.
It only gets complicated whenever it does nothing, whether they succeed or fail.
Whoa. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Why did Garrett and miss? And then claw at Garrett and miss. All right, go ahead and do Griffin 10 now.
Okay, here it comes.
Yeah, Griffin 10 is done.
All right, you can go ahead and do 12 now. So Garrett. Garrett is going to be cursed.
And 12 free to do whatever it's going to do.
All right, it is going to bite at Oxnard and miss. Claw at Oxnard and miss. All right, Oxnard.
Oxnard is going to minus 5 on his attack. And miss. And minus 5 on his attack. And hit. And that will be Oxnard's turn.
All right. Griffin 12, go ahead, Mr. Garrett.
Okay.
All right, missed.
Rapier. Again.
Nice.
Emrys.
I continue my assault against 11.
You seem to be hearing that a lot.
Yay.
One of the kitty birds.
I have one attack left. I will make a running jump to land here and attack Griffin 1.
Alright.
Alright, I mean, it kind of looks like the party has it well in hand. Toss a firebolt. Miss at him.
Minus 5. Swing. Minus 5.
Did you roll the second one?
Did Fancy Grounds freeze up? I've tried to roll it twice. Nothing's happened.
No, it looks... There you go.
There it is. All right,
you hit.
Alrighty, ends my turn. Boom.
Alrighty, so this one's going to bite at Garrett and then claw at Garrett and hit on the claws. And Garrett, I need a constitution saving throw.
Okay.
And you failed.
Oh no! Well, that sucks. All right, so my go.
Yep.
And a mist.
Yes.
You're up.
All right. Let's do this.
Mortality clarified in a single strike.
Is there anybody else? I'll fucking hit somebody else. Who wants it?
Come here, Oxnard. Where are you at? All right. So, you easily dispatch those. But... it comes with a price. Garrett, Emrys, Oxnard, and Mist. You are all now cursed.
What?
It wasn't me, guys, I swear.
You have an insatiable craving for horse flesh. And... in addition to this, beasts with a challenge rating of two or lower are scared of you and treat you as hostile.
Fantastic.
Excellent.
So would this be a greater restoration to get rid of this or a lesser restoration to get rid of this?
It says remove curse or similar effect. I don't think lesser restoration does it, but greater ought to.
All right, so you've got the mask. Do you head on back up to the boat? Or the ship? I'm sorry.
Yeah, we might have to stop for a horse.
Yeah.
but we can burn one of our charges to get rid of this thing, right?
It'd be four charges.
Yeah, four charges for greater restoration.
Or I could...
Do you have remove curse?
I can pick it up on my next long rest. It's part of my...
What a coincidence.
It's part of,
all right.
Part of my third level spell slot. And I've got... Let's see. I've got three a day.
Three of them. Someone's going to be eating a horse for a couple days.
Yeah.
Well, a day or two.
So why wasn't I cursed there?
You have too far away. You have to have killed...
Oh, okay.
One of them.
Did I actually kill one?
You did, yes.
Okay. Your guardians did.
Yeah. That's right. Okay. Yeah.
All right, so let's pull up the little map here. And where are y'all headed to next?
Morgur's Mound?
Morgur's
Is that right?
Mound.
I beg your pardon. I think we should go ahead and level up on this long rest.
I don't know that you have enough XP.
I mean, there was a set of stables at Xanthral's Keep, right? And it's on the way.
Stop in there and maybe get some dinner?
Maybe get some dinner.
Because I think it was the stables there where we captured that dwarf, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Let's eat us some horse.
Well, how long does it take to get there?
Boston, Mass. 16250.
Let's see.
Is that supposed to mean something? 16250?
Nope, not at all. It means something to me, but not to y'all.
Sure.
Let's see here. Airship travel. So y'all are at... Where the hell were y'all at?
We were at Shining White, and I think Morgur's Mound was the planned next stop.
That is 160 miles.
At 8 miles an hour, that's 20 hours.
So let us see what happens on your journey.
Are we going to kill our third green dragon?
There seems to be an abundance of them. You experience strong winds for...
All right.
Too much horse flesh, guys.
For 1 hour.
Well, if we got that long rest, let me see, that would have been on the boat. And so I could take at least three of us off the curse list.
So it adds 40 hours to your trip.
Fucking Jesus, man.
All right.
It turns a 20 hours into 60 hours. Oh, my God. Wins.
Well, that's enough time to clear all four of us.
All right.
I mean, really, with Oxnard, can we tell the difference?
Yeah, well, he was going to be the last one anyway. I figure he probably wouldn't mind the craving.
Don't hate on the Goliath.
I don't hate on the Goliath. I respect you. Yeah. For eating horse meat.
It's going to be two random encounters. I have a better system.
I was excited because I thought it was... I made a mistake and thought it was horse meat.
We've all eaten McDonald's before. It's nothing different than what we've done in real life.
There's a lot of cultures that eat horse.
I was ready to eat me some whores.
Their meat?
Their meat.
Whatever there is.
Yeah, I thought you said whores mates.
I'll eat any of that.
All right, so let me get you... Oh, one thing of note. As you are rising up from the last place you were at, the Shining Wind or whatever it was, you notice that the cliffs and the like the paths on the ground and stuff, when you got up high and looked down, you could see that it was in the shape of a griffin.
And we did notice that on the way in.
I'm not really convinced.
Yeah.
Maybe a rocking horse with an upright tail?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not seeing griffin there.
Yeah. At best, rocking horse.
At best, a rocking horse.
I'm seeing an Indian with a bow.
So you look at it sideways, maybe like a midget ninja.
It's a howling wolf.
I will let y'all... The spikes on the center of this thing are, in fact, bones. Yep, that is correct. So I will let y'all... Where do you want to land on this thing?
Look, this one's like a lizard or a snake.
That's kind of what it looks like on this from the side.
Yeah. Looks like a dragon or something.
Oh, right there. There.
Oh, we can do that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, right there, too. Yeah, I hadn't scrolled all the way over. That's even better.
Yeah.
All right.
So... where do you want to dig, guys? Unless, is there anything on the surface that looks like it would be a relic?
There's some burial cairns on the other side, and then some of the top horn.
This is the...
Right there looks to be disturbed around it.
Let's head over there.
That's the tip of the penis.
Okay, remember when we asked which giant lord had the best treasure for a wizard?
Yeah.
It says, first you must prove yourself. When the human barbarians came to these lands, they fought our kind and stole our relics, burying them in the ground. The humans built altars to Uthgar, their god king, atop these relics and surrounded their altars with burial mounds. Go to these mounds, retrieve one or more of our lost relics, and bring them here as a tribute.
Right. That's what we've been doing. We've been grave robbing.
Right. It's just actually seeing the burial mounds this time is like cool. All
right, so go ahead and give me some investigation or perception. All right, Mist, you are able to successfully dig up this gold-plated fire giant's tooth. And as you do so, the ground begins to tremble underneath your feet.
I yell, heads up.
You look to the northeast, and you see four animated Thunderbeast skeletons rise up out of the ground.
Thunderbeast!
Thundercats!
Oh.
Actually, Misty would be up there since you...
Those are big.
And everybody roll initiative.
Matt, what's Barath doing way down there?
Yeah, what is Barath doing way down there? Let me put myself up here.
Supervising.
Apparently.
All right. Mist, you're up first.
Okay. I am going to, that's the closest one. Okay, I am going to step out a bit. And I'm going to take a shot with my bow.
Do shots.
What?
Do shots.
Oh, do shots. I see what you're saying. Ooh, and that's a hit. And it's a minimum damage of 4. And then I'm going to... step back. And then I'm going to try to find the combat tracker.
You don't get assassinate with ranged weapons, do you?
Oh crap! I keep forgetting that. Yeah, he hasn't acted yet.
Yeah, go ahead. You're good. You can roll.
So, so that means I get advantage, right?
Right, which would allow you to apply your sneak dice.
Right. So okay. So I didn't crit, but I did hit. So he takes.
I gave him as
another.
Okay, so 14 total damage.
He takes another 10. Yeah.
Okay. All right, so let's see here.
One day I'll remember to do that. This doesn't happen very often.
That moves to there. Garrett, you're up.
Ah, you little piece of shit. So... All right, bonus action. Give me something to beat on him with.
All right. There you go.
Okay. Oh, a bunny. Neat.
The Easter bunny.
Oh, you stupid POS. All right. And I missed with that, too. Well, craptastic. I'll, stand my ground and pass my turn.
All right.
So how far away are they?
From you?
The squares are... How far are the squares? Are they 5 foot squares?
Yep.
All right, and since they're skeletons, I will use the maul. They don't classify as giants, do they?
They do not.
Yep, so then we'll go with the maul. First one missed. Second one hit. And that will end my turn.
All right.
Oh, vulnerable to your bludgeoning. I like it.
That will dash. All right, Barith.
Suppose I'll move up a little bit and flame, firebolt rather.
One.
Yeah.
I got one.
Look at that.
All right. Guy.
Let's go look back and say I had this under control.
Is this my first kill?
I will dash to there. I think direct kill. Yeah. All right, Emrys.
I will I think I'll just magic missile Thunder Beast Skeleton 8.
All right, this guy here.
Nice damage.
Very consistent damage.
Move to there.
Damn, they move.
He was they're dashing. Otherwise, I would just hand wave it because they'd be dead, I would imagine, by the time they got to you.
Okay, right there. All right, hold on a sec. I gotta change my dice color.
Yeah, your dice have been really off tonight.
All right, and I'm going to action surge because I don't like this. Damn, okay. I think Chris put some kind of curse on my dice.
That new extension I put in.
It's my turn.
Alright, so this guy here is going to bite at Oxnard and hit.
Ooh, they bite.
I'm going to I'm going to Stone's Endurance that.
Okay.
They like to use the chompers. No, we're all good, thanks.
What I'd like for fancy grounds to start working properly.
You want me to do it for you?
Yeah, if you could, because I can't get my action thing to move.
Rolled for minimal heal. All right, Emerus, you're up.
Alrighty. I will, I guess, just move up to number two and swing three times.
Oh my god.
Oh dear. Stack them up.
One in 8,000. Can he do it?
Let's keep it going. Let's action surge.
Alright.
Three.
Chris turned.
Oh my god.
Chris turned the extension off.
That's right.
That was a nice roll, too. One off of max?
Yeah.
And end my turn with that.
All right, Garrett. It started out so poorly, and then it just came around.
It's actually five off of max.
Oh, I was thinking you were rolling a bunch of d6s. Those are d8s and d6s.
All right, Garrett.
All right, spiritual weapon will hover up into position. Okay, and try to chill touch this undead POS again. And miss again.
Okay, you need to change your dice color.
I'm not holding my tongue right when I cast the spell.
I think Chris needs to turn off the extension, right. Screw the PCs.
Yeah. Right, missed.
Miss is going to come up after dropping his bow, pull his one rapier, and swing away. And now he's upset.
Don't you have two rapiers?
Yeah, but I had to drop my bow, and you can only draw one weapon.
Oh, I thought you had the feat that gave you plus one AC and that. Oh, that's Emerus, isn't it?
That yeah, I have.
I'm thinking of the other dual wielder in the party.
All right,
Firebolt. I thought I'd be able to snipe another one, guys.
That was a good attempt.
Move to there. What's his reach? Not far enough.
I think that extension is installed whenever he gives me that damn bunny.
All right, missed.
All right. One down.
I mean, technically two down.
All right.
Well, yeah. One down. You're right.
All righty. Mother trucker.
All
gave up on the chill touch.
All right. I will dash to there. I will just step to here and bite at Oxnard and hit.
Second wind.
I think you already used it.
No, you stone's endurance.
Okay.
You can only use second wind as a bonus action.
Bonus action.
Oh, okay.
I like that you were waiting for that. You were so ready to say that, and then you're like, ah, wah, wah, wah.
If you use Stone's Endurance already, okay. Alright, alright, Oxnard, drop.
Alright, let's try this again.
Second wind is a bonus action. And
second wind, isn't it? Alrighty. Now we'll do our attack.
Alright.
Did you do black on black? Cause
yeah, I figured what the hell. I can't roll a number, so what the hell? I might as well just roll blanks.
And for that, you got a one.
And you actually missed him.
I thought I said a hit earlier.
Nope, you didn't have him targeted.
I think you saw a heal.
Yeah, you saw a heal.
All right, well, let me target him then. My second attack.
There you go.
Does that hit?
Yep.
Yeah.
Same damage. And that ends my turn.
All right. Emrys.
My bad.
I will move up and... attack three times. I'm sorry.
Is that mist I heard in the background?
No, that's my dogs for some reason. They just started. I'll check that out in a second.
Right, do they see mist?
Yep. Mist is out walking in the street.
Consistent hits. There you go.
And that's my turn.
All right. Barith?
All right. I'll gaze at the Thunder Beast.
It is not impressed.
Oh. All right.
All right. Missed.
Ba-ba-ba-ba.
Yeah.
Nice.
Tide turns. Very nice.
Ooh, that's a couple dice.
Yeah.
Right, reach out and touch someone. And I'll back away.
And they can't, Shug and Grass, they can't take reactions, correct?
Correct.
Alright, so this guy is going to... go after. Odds are Garrett, evens are missed. I think he's gonna try to bite missed. Hit. You got your, yep, you do. Hi, Garrett.
All right, I'll take the opportunity to attack. I'm gonna try to move back. To there.
Alrighty.
Move the spiritual weapon.
That song's been playing way too much tonight.
I hate that bunny.
That's a big old bunny.
God dang it.
Alrighty. I will move up and swing three times.
Wow.
Two whiffs and a crit.
Alright, Oxnard. Right when I get ready to say, you know what, guys, let's just hand wave this, you all start missing.
Yeah, it gets interesting. Oh, put that color back, man.
Alright. Emrys.
Alright, let's try this again.
Redemption. All solid hits.
All right, it's probably got like 3 hit points left.
Probably so.
So, guys, remind me of the rule. Uncanny Dodge is actually a reaction. So, does that reset at the round or at my turn?
At your turn.
At your turn.
Yeah.
Okay, so I wouldn't have it now if he got me.
Probably not.
All right.
He's pretty safe.
We're going to go ahead and just kill this guy because he's got 4 hit points left. Well, I don't know. Oxnard would have just missed him. He would have hit him. Okay.
Dazed. Reeling. About to break.
Yep, so Oxnard would have just killed him.
Crit 19.
Cool.
Alright, so...
I think that... Was that the first time that would have actually activated for you? Yeah, the crit on 19. Is that the first time?
Yeah. No, I think I had one.
Happened before.
Yeah, before.
Oh, maybe on the Remoraz, but yeah.
That's the first time I rolled a double-digit freaking roll in, like, the last 30 rolls.
All right, so what would y'all like to do? Do you want to jump back in your boat and head to the next one?
How many? Do we have 3 of these artifacts now?
Yep, you have 3.
Yeah, we do.
And there are 4 total?
No. There's a whole bunch of spots, but my initial proposal had been that we hit the nearest 4. So, like, make a circle from Great Worm Cavern to Shining Light to Morgur's Mound.
Yeah,
to
I knew I had the Raven number 4 Rock. In my head, and I wonder where I got that. Let's do it. Do you want to go back with 3, or do you want to hit the 4th? Do it.
So, I mean, we may only have needed 1.
The notes said that the more we had,
like, the more options we got or something.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm willing to go home with 3.
Check for 3, X for 4.
What do I do if I just want to go to sleep?
All right, so it looks like y'all are headed back then. All right, give me 1 second. So y'all head back to the
inn
place. Let me map real quick.
Does this choose our branches for us?
It does, yes. Right. Go into here, give that map a minute to load. Let me know when everybody's got it.
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
Check monitor.
All right, so you arrive back. Harshnag is waiting for you. He is with you. Let me grab that fella.
All right, Harshnag, you can carry this shield / gong.
You couldn't tell him that Oxnard had his wang on it.
Yeah, I'm just gonna think about it constantly while he's carrying it.
A teabagged
shoe. Hey, Harshnag, does this gong smell funny to you? Could you take a whiff?
The texture's really weird. Rub it up against your face.
All right, so let's see here. Y'all arrive, you place the artifacts on the altar. And as you do so, three statues slide out of the wall. Let's see here. You had the broken shield. So the statue of Storvald slides out of the wall. You had the gold-plated tooth. The statue of Zalto slides out of the wall. And you also had the mask. So the statue of Sansri slides out of the wall. So, all right. With that, the Oracle says, "You have done a great deed for all giants. A new path lies before you."
Who are these, and respectively?
The
look at those statues.
The broken shield is Storvald. The tooth is Zalto, and the mask is Sansri.
Okay. Who are each of these?
They tell you that they are giant lords.
Which giant lords are each of these?
The one second, so let me find that.
Well, one of them should be a frost, one of them's a fire, but I don't know what the one with the mask is.
The mask is a storm giant.
So we got a frost, a fire, and a storm giant. Okay.
Who are the frost and fire?
Frost is the shield. Fire is the tooth.
We already knew how to get to the fire giant.
So it asks you, you know, which, you obviously, you have to go defeat the giant and get the conch. So it asks you, which giant do you want to go after? And it will tell you the way and how to get to it.
Oh, that's kind of interesting. Fire.
Storm giants are the strongest, aren't they?
Yeah.
They're the ones more likely to...
What's the order, like hill, rock, frost, fire, storm, cloud, in terms of strength?
I have no idea.
It's something along those lines. You're not far off.
Would our characters know that? Would we know? Would we have been told the lore, or how would we...
Yeah, I want to say that somebody. I want to say that somebody actually told y'all the hierarchy at one point in time.
It wasn't Harshnag himself.
Yeah, I think he did.
Oh no, it wasn't Harshnag. It was the dude in the floating tower.
Oh, that dude. Yeah. Zephyrococcus, whatever his name was.
Beard.
Beard, yeah.
xiphoid process. Yeah.
Yeah. The Tressum.
So of the three, we have, which one's the lowest tier guy?
Probably Frost.
I think Frost and Fire are about even. But yeah, Hill's definitely the lowest. Storm, they're the ones that sometimes make their homes in the sea, which makes me think Conch.
I thought everyone had a Conch.
Nope, there's only one.
Oh, so we might have to like kill multiple of these guys until we find the one with the Conch?
Or we might have to make a deal.
Yeah.
Is it Storm that make their home in the sea, or is it...
No, Storm walked the seas.
Okay.
Yeah.
At least they typically do.
So which are the three again that we have right now?
Storvald, which is a Frost, Zalto, which is Fire, and Sansuri, which is the Storm.
Okay, I say Fire. That's my vote.
I kind of want to fight whoever's strongest. These fights tonight were pretty tame.
Yeah, we didn't fight any giants.
I would like to meet Storvald.
All right, so hang on, let's do this.
He sounds like a good warrior to have a shield.
Are we going to keep going? Because it sounds like I need to get something to drink.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't get a drink. not saying that anything dramatic's going to happen or anything, but we're close to wrapping. I'll put it that way. All right.
Which one's the storm giant?
Sansuri. Is Sansuri a storm giant?
Yes.
Whichever one. No, it's a cloud. Whichever one has their castle in the clouds.
Okay, that's
flying castle.
That's cloud giant.
Oh, there's an actual cloud giant. Okay, yes, that is a cloud giant.
There's six types. There's hill, fire, frost, cloud, storm, and what's the one I'm missing?
Cloud's the second strongest after storm.
All right, so you've got cloud, fire, and frost.
I wonder if there's an artifact out there to get to storm giants. Well, we already made our trip.
It looks like no matter what, I mean, even if people haven't finished voting, it looks like Sansuri's the one that...
All right.
Damn it, I'm the X on that one.
So the Oracle responds, travel southeast to the untamed moors and look to the sky for Lynn Armal, the castle of the cloud giant countess. The conch you seek is in a secret chest. Search the highest spire. And with that, all of the artifacts disappear and the statues slide back into the wall.
So are we going to get wrecked by picking the hardest of the giants?
Oh, no, I didn't like that.
I'm thinking, yeah. And
I mean, I want to fight the hardest of them, but...
And they're the ones that use magic also.
All right, so with that, Harshnag exits out and says, you know, let's go.
He's like, F this, I'm out.
So since we've made our decision, can I ask, if we had done more artifacts, would we have been able to fight the cloud giants?
You mean the storm giants or whatever?
Storm giants, yeah. The biggest of the giants.
Negative. The cloud giants were the hardest ones that you would be able to fight.
All right.
So, as you step out, you hear the crunch of frost under heavy feet. As an enormous one of these bursts through the main doors of the temple, the great worm pays no mind to the statues here. Instead, it fixes its hateful gaze on you. Everybody roll the initiative.
Oh, snap.
What are dragons doing here?
Well, remember that the, what was it? We asked something about dragons.
Oh, yeah, and they're... Okay.
Yeah. Before the end, what role do dragons play in this conflict between the giants? Before the end, this will be made clear. They are one and the same.
All right, Emrys, you are up.
I take cover behind the center statue, and I drink the potion of heroism.
All right.
Bigger dragon than the one we fought in the air. 4x4.
Yeah.
If you wanna, if somebody will give me a history check, I will tell you what kind of dragon it is. Just so you know how screwed you are.
Blue.
How screwed we are.
I'm gonna say it's blue.
Barath, you are able to recall that this is an ancient dragon.
Oh. Fuck.
All right, Harshnag, I think this one's up to you, buddy. We did the work of getting us here.
All right, Emrys, did you drink your potion, you said?
Yeah, but I can't apply it.
Okay.
I basically get the blessed spell for an hour, and I get 10 temporary hit points that last an hour.
Alright, so let me give you your temp. Who, does anybody have Bless prepared?
I do.
Can you just drop it on Emrys?
Sure will.
Well, it takes an action, so that's all I can do.
Alright. So Harshnag looks to y'all and says, "You, go! You know what you must do. I will distract the foul beast." And he charges for the giant, or for the dragon.
Don't do it, Harshnag. Your bulge isn't big enough.
All right. And she charges forward at Harshnag. And will make a bite attack and hit.
Yeah, he's not going to last all.
Claw once. And claw again. Alright, missed.
Fuck! Alright, I'm going to go 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. And I am going to... Bonus action, I think I get 30 more, don't I?
As a rogue? You get your movement again, but you're a cat person, so you can move 180 if you're bonus action dashing, because you've got move, double move, dash, bonus action move. And because you're a cat person,
okay, so
you double it.
That's 90? Okay, so 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150, 160, 100, fuck this, man. All y'all can fuck yourselves. Okay, so that's...
Oh, you want to go down the stairs.
Yeah, you want to be running down the stairs.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah, that's what I meant.
Mist is setting up for y'all to drag it out to the trap. All right, Barath.
All right, that's 15. Bonus action, Misty Step. Finish my move. And then... Action to move.
All right.
You're doing great, Harshnag. You've got her on the ropes. Him on the ropes. Whatever it is.
What would you like to do, sir?
Did we lose?
I'm moving. That's a double move. Done.
All right. Garrett.
That's my double.
Right. You've been counting it?
Yep.
All All right, to Garrett, you're up again.
Double there.
All right. So Harshnag takes his great axe and swing it and hits the statue of Anim the Allfather and knocks a chip off, sending it flying to the ground. And as he does so, the temple begins to shudder and pieces of the ceiling begin to collapse. And he yells at y'all, "Flee! Your fate lies elsewhere!" As he backs up.
We're on that shit.
Fly, you fools.
One on his attack roll when he hit the statue.
And let's see here. She whips her tail around at him as he backs away. And hits.
Oh, that poor bastard.
All right, Demeris.
Double move to there. Okay. And that'll be my turn.
Oxnard.
Don't move there, in my turn.
Alright, give me 1 second. Let me check something.
She immediately turns and breath buckles almost to a cluster.
Yeah. Yep. It was my plan all along. She reloaded the spring trap, so you're all gonna get crushed. Alright, so she suddenly raises up and lets loose a giant roar.
Oh, is that Frightful Presence?
And...
Well, we were all running anyway.
Everybody is frightened except for Garrett, who stands strong. And then
still she, running.
She charges forward at Harshnag. All right, Mist.
Mist is going to...
stand still for one round so he can repeat it the next.
Mist is going to cast Sleet Storm with the Shard of Ice Rune right there. And that's just a DC 17 save for freezing rain and sleet fall in a 20-foot tall, 40-foot radius centered on a point you choose. The area is heavily obscured and exposed. Flames in the area are doused. The ground in the area is covered with slick ice, making it difficult terrain. When the creature enters a spell area for the first time on a turn, it starts its turn there. It must make a dexterity saving throw. On a failed save, it falls prone. If a creature is concentrating on the spell's area, the creature must make a successful constitution. Yeah, so that's happening, and then I'm going to move another 30 feet away. Fuck this.
And on that's on its turn that has to make the save?
Yeah, it's when it enters, which doesn't count because I cast it on them, so it's on their, if they start their turn there.
Okay.
I'll be honest, when I heard you were casting Sleep Storm, I thought you were trying to trip us so that it'd be easier for you to get away.
No.
Move, dash, bonus action, Misty Step, pass.
All right. All right, Mist.
60 feet.
Oxnard, all right. Emrys.
Alright, I move there.
Alright, Barrett. I will continue to advance
towards the exit. Bonus action, Misty stepping along the way.
You'll see in just a second. Let me give you those XP back.
You're too slow, kitty cat. I think you and I are going to have to leave them.
That is 1,000. Alright. So that was Emrys. Barath, did you move already?
Yeah.
Harshnag. Alright, so Harshnag moves farther back. And as the stones in front of the door collapse, blocking your view, the last thing you hear is the dragon roar and what sounds like lightning erupt out of its mouth.
Did the sleet storm at least hurt it any?
And let's see what happens. Alright. And with that, you hear the sounds of battle continue as you make your way out and board your airship. Harshnag's fate unknown.
Unknown.
The Unknown Whom by Rob Toohey.
I'm going to say
The Unknown Whom by Rob Toohey.
I think it's 10-1, he's dead.
So here's the question, guys. Do we wait for the dragon to leave and then go and make sure that Harshnag has a proper burial, including relieving him of any items he was carrying?
Well, you gotta figure out.
I mean, he would have wanted it that way, right?
Oh, absolutely. The only
snap! I need a long rest, level 7.
Can we get back in there to even get to his body?
Yeah, the place completely collapsed. As far as you know.
So he's got a proper burial.
Especially if he was a stone giant. Which he wasn't, obviously.
Yeah, but he died in battle, which is honorable to him.
Alright, so as you see, everybody leveled up. Congratulations. There are some items. There's some gemstones, a potion of climbing, and a potion of invulnerability. If you want the potion of climbing, go ahead and roll a d20 in chat.
Be 34,000 for level 8.
All right, Thank you. So I'm going to roll a d10, and we'll start, let's see here. Looks like Oxnard's getting the potion of climbing. All right, whoever would like the potion of invulnerability, go ahead and roll in chat. Shit, I did not mean to erase that. Was that 3920 for the XP?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, Emrys gets the potion of invulnerability, and we'll. Does anybody want these jewels, or do y'all just want to cash them out?
Cash out.
Yeah, cash out.
Yeah, you can cash out.
Oh, the jeweled warhammer. Is that a weapon?
It is a weapon.
Does anybody want that? Who can use it?
I think we sell it.
Yeah, it's nothing special. Yeah. It just got jewels on it.
It had one jewel on it. In the hilt, if I recall.
Alright, so we'll cash it out then.
Spell slots have increased.
805 gold.
And we may level up?
Absolutely.
Alright.
I was totally hoping that y'all would, like, want to fight that thing.
But as soon as he fucking laid down the hammer on Harshneck, I'm like, yeah, peace out, bitch.
We're going to need to collect the Sword of a Thousand Truths and have a montage of leveling up.
Yep, just go kill wild boars out in the forest for a few months.
Right.
I'm just going to skip level 7 and go right to level 8, okay?
Where's the nearest farm? We're going to go kill everyone's pigs.
That's right.
I don't really get anything at level 7, so I might as well skip it and go to level 8.
Oh. Yeah, that's, sounds like the way to go.
Don't you get...
I get to half...
Yeah, that's an initiative bonus. You get half your proficiency to your initiative.
And to any checks or whatever.
That you're not proficient in, but practically speaking, what you care about is a bonus to your initiative.
And I added that in there for you, Oxnard, so you now get +3 to your initiative.
And you get half, so it shouldn't be a plus, okay, well, so 1.5. So
you round up.
So it'd be that 2.
One. Oh, you round up so for that be, one?
Yeah,
Jack of all trades is round down, but Remarkable Athlete is round up.
Okay.
And now that goes for like all the dexterity and strength and what else?
I don't remember if con's included or not.
Nope, strength, dex. It's strength, dex, or con, yeah.
Yeah, but there is no con saves there. So like acrobatics, I'd get half instead of added to it, right?
I mean, if you're already proficient, it doesn't do anything for you. But yes, right, if you're not proficient in acrobatics, you now are half proficient in it.
Right, I'm saying the things I'm not proficient in.
Okay, cool. You're going through and checking it. All right, so just a reminder, there will not be a game next Wednesday.
Ed
will be at Winter Fantasy gaming it with all the cool kids. So we might do a one-shot or something that night if y'all would be interested. You know what I'll probably end up doing, Rob, is buying that thing we were talking about last night and maybe doing that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, roll up some PCs and see how fast I can kill y'all.
Well, that sounds like great fun.
So we are going to play next week, or we're just not going to do this?
Yeah, we can, if y'all want to, we can totally play. We can, if I get that, y'all can roll up like some level 4 characters or 5 or whatever and run through that.
Okay, so the reason you're not doing the game next week is because of lack of time for preparation?
No. I'm gone next week.
Oh, you're gone. Okay,
yes,
sorry.
Yes, I'm headed to Winter Fantasy.
Oh, right, okay.
I'll be playing with
the... I misunderstood. I thought it was... he was talking about his son.
Nope. Who, we'll talk about that in a second. Hang on a second.
Okay.
All right, everybody. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to stop back on Saturday for our one-shots, and then Sunday's my birthday stream. We'll be starting Curse of Strahd. So we will talk to y'all later. Like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitch. Subscribe on YouTube. All that kind of cool crap. Talk to you later.